local taxes, fees, and charges. This is another source of revenue of the local government unit. Sa mga highly urbanized cities, marami silang kinikita dito. Local business taxes, part 2, charges and fees, levied and collected by the LGUs. Halimbawa, itong Sintrayo Mall, an Ayala Mall, saan ba to? Cagayan de Oro City. Ano ang collection dito ng Cagayan de Oro City? Real property tax on building and land. And then sa local business taxes, yung Ayala mismo magbabayad ng local business tax because they are operating a business in Cagayan de Oro City. And not only that, lahat ng business establishments sa loob ng mall na yan, napakalaking mall yan, kukuha ng mayor's permit. Magbabayad sila ng business tax, magbabayad sila ng kung ano-ano pang fees and charges like para sa basura, para sa health, para sa fire inspection fee. Yan, marami pa silang babayaran. Income yan ng LGU. LGUs with taxing powers. Sinong pwedeng mangolekta dyan? Province, municipality, city, barangay. Ano naman ang makukolekta ng barangay? Kasi it is required by the local government code na before the city will issue mayor's permit, dapat meron munang barangay clearance yung mga establishments sa barangay where they are located. Halimbawa, barangay 1, 2, 3, yung business mo, doon ang negosyo mo mismo, kukuha ka ng barangay permit muna. So meron ding sharing barangay sa meron ding kikitain ng barangay sa mga business establishment. Fundamental principle. Taxation shall be uniform in each LGU. Pinag-usapan na natin kung anong uniform. Same class, same rate. Those who belong to one class should be taxed at the same rate. Or those who belong to the same class should be taxed at the same rate. Taxes, fees, charges, and other imposition shall be equitable. Equitable means ability to pay. Be levied and collected only for public purposes. Siyempre, taxes, fees, and charges shall be collected only for public purposes. Anyway, napakalawak naman ng meaning ng public purpose. Not unjust, excessive, oppressive, or confiscatory. It should be fair, affordable. Not in restraint of trade. Yan, ito na yun. Not contrary to law. Alin ang not contrary to law? Yung ordinance collecting or imposing the taxes, fees, and charges. It should not be contrary to law, public policy, national economic policy, or in restraint of trade. The collection or imposition shall not be let to any private person. Baka naman kasi ibulsa nila. Pinag-usapan na natin yan kanina sa real property tax. The revenue shall inure solely to the benefit of and be subject to disposition by the LGU unless otherwise specifically provided. So, pera ng LGU, collection ng LGU, pera nila, sila ang bahala kung paano yung disposition basta within the bounds of law. Pwede bang collection sa taxes ng isang city, ibigay sa isang city? Pwede. Basta mayroong authority, mayroong ordinansa. Halimbawa, mayor ka ng Manila, gusto mong tumakbong presidente or senador sa sunod na halalan, nagkaroon ng bagyong paeng, yung lugar na medyo mahina ka, binigyan mo ng assistance, financial assistance, yung LGU doon. Pwede yan, that is allowed by law. Anyway, that is still for public purpose. Progressive system of taxation. Graduated rates. Limitation. So these are prohibitions. LGU cannot collect taxes being collected by the national government. Halimbawa, value-added tax, hindi pwedeng kolektahin ng LGU. Sa national government yan. Kung gusto nila, pwede silang kumolekta ng local business taxes at a graduated rate, but not value-added tax. Because ang value-added tax sa national government yan. That are exempt under national law. Sinabi na ng statute or national law na exempt yan, huwag nang sisingilin ng LGU. Huwag naman magsasabi ang LGU na exempt sila sa national law, pero hindi sila exempt sa ordinansya natin. Dahil dito sa ordinansya natin, dapat silang magbayad. That is in violation of the provisions of the local government code. Fees and charges on the national government agencies and instrumentalities in LGUs. Huwag mong kukolektahan ng taxes, fees, and charges ang national government at baka magkagulo. Agencies and instrumentalities and kapwa LGU. Hindi mo pwedeng singilin yan. Rules. Provinces are empowered to impose taxes within its territorial jurisdiction. These taxes cannot be imposed by municipalities. So taxes that are imposable by the province cannot be imposed by municipalities. Kasi mayroong mga boundaries yan. Yung para sa probinsya na buwis na pwedeng singilin, hindi pwedeng singilin ng municipality. Yung taxes naman na pwedeng singilin ng municipality cannot be imposed and collected by the provinces. Iba yung taxes para sa probinsya, iba naman yung taxes para sa municipality. Ayan. Municipalities can impose taxes which cannot be imposed by the provinces. That's why yung local government code natin, ibinigay ang mga taxes na pwedeng kolektahin ng municipality para sa kanila lang yan. Hindi pwedeng singilin ng probinsya. Kahit pa kung iisipin, mas boss nila yung probinsya. Yung probinsya naman, yung mga taxes na pwedeng singilin nila, hindi pwedeng singilin ng municipality. Halimbawa, transfer tax. That is given by the local government code to provinces. So the municipalities, even if the real property situated in each municipality, halimbawa municipality ABC, hindi yan pwedeng singilin ng municipality kasi exclusive yan sa probinsya ang tax na yan. Kuha mo. Cities can impose taxes within each jurisdiction on taxes that may be imposed by provinces and municipalities. Naka-enumerate sa local government code ang mga taxes na pwedeng singilin ng probinsya at pwedeng singilin ng o re-impose ng municipality. Paano kung yung city nasa loob ng probinsya? Pwede bang yung mga taxes na kinokolekta ng probinsya kolektahin ng city? Yes, pwede. Kaya nga, can impose taxes within each jurisdiction, basta within each territorial jurisdiction. Huwag namang maniningil ng buwis yung city sa labas na ng teritoryo niya dahil away yan. On taxes that may be imposed by provinces and municipalities. Barangays have power to impose taxes, fees, and charges which can never be imposed by cities, municipalities and provinces. Mga simpleng taxes lang naman ito. Halimbawa, yung mga yung mga pansabong na manok, pwede yan singilin ng barangay. Yung barangay clearance, pwedeng singilin ng barangay. Hindi pwedeng barangay clearance isingilin ng city. Hindi, dahil hindi yan para sa kanila. Oh, we have an example. Halimbawa, etong yellow, colored yellow, na rectangle, is the territorial jurisdiction of the province of Camarines Sur. Ilorca City is within the province of Camarines Sur. Barangay Francia is within the territorial jurisdiction of Ilorca City. It is one of the barangays in Ilorca. Meron naman, Municipality of Pili is within the province of Camarines Sur. Okay, ang issue dito is sand and gravel tax. Dito muna tayo sa city. Merong sand and gravel na kinukuha sa within the territorial jurisdiction of Ilorca. Halimbawa, sa Barangay Francia. Pwede bang maningil ng sand and gravel tax yung Barangay Francia? No. Kasi they are not empowered to collect or impose such local tax. That is exclusively imposable by the city. Okay, pwede bang mangulikta dyan ang province? Hindi pwede. Kasi exclusive yan sa city being within the territorial jurisdiction of the city of Ilorca. Okay, so hindi pwedeng makialam ang province of Camarines Sur, hindi pwedeng mangulikta ng sand and gravel tax na nanggagaling sa Ilorca City. Okay. Hindi rin pwedeng mangulikta ang Francia, Barangay Francia, kahit pa doon sa kanila kinukuha yung sand and gravel. Dahil wala silang power to impose such tax. Ito naman, Municipality of Pili. Yung Municipality of Pili, merong pinagkukunan na sand and gravel. Doon mismo sa territorial jurisdiction ng Municipality of Pili. Pwede bang maningil ng sand and gravel tax ang Municipality of Pili? No, because that is not a tax imposable by a municipality. Ang pwedeng mangulikta dyan is the province of Camarines Sur. The source of sand and gravel being within a municipality in a province of Camarines Sur. So, ang pwede lang mangulikta ng sand and gravel tax sa sand and gravel na kinukuha sa municipality ay ang probinsya. Pagka naman kinukuha sa city, ang city lang ang pwedeng mangulekta. Hindi pwede yung barangay, kahit doon pa sa barangay niya kinukuha, hindi rin pwede ang probinsya kasi it is not a municipality. Ilorca is not a municipality but a city. Common revenue raising powers of LGUs. Ito pwedeng mangulekta ang barangay, municipality, probinsya, or city basta qualified sila. LGUs are authorized to impose and collect the following fees and charges. Service fees and charges for any service render. Kung ang nag-render ng service, city, kolektahin ng city yung service fees and charges. Kung barangay, barangay ang mangulekta. Kaya lang naman ang nagbigay ng servisyo yung city, ang mangulekta yung probinsya. Hindi pwede yan. Kung sinong nagtrabaho, kung sinong nagbigay ng servisyo, kanya yung collection, yung revenue. Public utility charges for the operation of public utilities owned, operated, and maintained by them within their territorial jurisdiction. Halimbawa, public market, yan. public market or bus terminal. Kung sinong may-ari ng bus terminal or public market, siyang mangulekta. Di ba? Kailangan namang bus terminal sa city, kukulektahin ng katabing municipality. Abay, hindi pwede yan. Aarestuhin sila ng mga police sa city. Toll fees or charges for the use of any public road, pier or wharf, waterway, bridge, ferry or telecommunication system funded and constructed by the LGU concern. Kung sinong may-ari ng property, siyang mangulekta ng toll fees or charges. Simple lang naman yan eh. Kung hindi sa'yo, huwag mong kukunin. The amount, rates and terms and conditions shall be fixed by the sanggunian concern in an ordinance. Kaya lang, halimbawa, toll fees and charges to be collected by barangay dahil sila ang may-ari ng property. The barangay ordinance will still be under review by the sangguniang panlungsod of the city or sangguniang bayan. Kung ordinance ng sangguniang bayan, that will still be reviewed by the sangguniang panlalawigan. Pero hindi naman pwedeng diktahan ng reviewing sanggunian yung LGU na nire-review nila yung ordinansa. They will just determine whether in accordance with the law or not yung ordinansa. Exempt from toll fees and charges, officers and enlisted men of the AFP and PNP on mission dumaan sa public road at nangungulikta ng toll fee yung city. Dumaan yung tatlong military truck. Meron silang merong aarestuhin na kriminal. Sisingilin mo pa ba yan? Ang bilis ng patakbo. Haharangan mo pa ba yan? On mission na eh. Post office personnel delivering mail. Physically handicapped and disabled citizens who are 65 years or older. Hindi lang senior citizen ang sinasabi dito. Physically handicapped and disabled. So, hindi sinasabi dito. Baka ang interpretasyon mo dahil 65 years old, senior citizen na. Kahit pa senior citizen yan, kung hindi naman siya disabled, hindi siya exempt. When public safety and welfare so requires, as ang gunang concerned, may discontinue the collection of the tolls and thereafter the said facility shall be free and open for public use. And ito ang mga buwis na exclusively imposable by the province to the exclusion of a municipality. Transfer tax, nandyan na. Tax on business of printing and publication. Halimbawa, sa municipality A, merong publisher ng libro o printer ng mga kung ano-anong materials. Ang pwedeng mangulekta ng tax on business of printing and publication ay ang probinsya. Franchise tax, sand and gravel tax, professional tax, o yung mga CPA na engaged in public practice, magbabayad ka if your office is situated in a certain municipality, magbabayad ka ng professional tax mo na 300 sa provincial treasurer's office. Unless authorized ng provincial treasurer ang municipal treasurer na mangulekta yung municipality. Pero merong mga provinces na ayaw na nilang bigyan ng authority yung municipality kasi makikihati pa yan sa kanila being collecting agent. Amusement tax on admission. fixed tax on delivery vehicles of producers, manufacturers, wholesalers, dealers or retailers in certain products. Halimbawa, yung mga malalaking delivery truck. Kung ang delivery truck registered sa municipality, yung fixed tax on the delivery vehicles will be paid sa probinsya. Ito naman, exclusively sa municipalities din ito. Municipalities may levy taxes, fees, and charges not otherwise levied by provinces. Basta wala doon sa provinces, sa province, pwede sa municipality. The municipality may impose taxes on the following businesses: manufacturers, assemblers, repackers, processors, brewers, distillers, rectifiers, and compounders or of liquors, distilled spirits and wines, or manufacturers of any article of commerce of whatever kind in or nature. On wholesalers, distributors, or dealers in any article of commerce of whatever kind or nature. Exporters and or manufacturers, millers, producers, wholesalers, distributors, dealers, or retailers of essential commodities such as rice and corn, etc. Napakadami. Basahin mo na lang. Yung mga business taxes, ang pwedeng maningil dyan, municipality. Kung municipality within a province. Cooking oil and cooking gas, laundry soap, detergents and medicine, agricultural implements, equipment and post-harvest facilities, fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides, herbicides, and other farm inputs. Poultry feeds and animal and other animal feeds. School supplies and cement. Retailers, contractors, banks, and other financial institutions. Peddlers in the sale of any merchandise or article of commerce. Fish for selling and licensing of weights and measures. Fishery rentals, fishing charges. Yan. Sa municipalities naman yan. Lahat ng may negosyo within the territorial jurisdiction of a municipality, dapat kumuha ng mayor's permit sa municipality. Pag kumuha ka ng mayor's permit, magbabayad ka ng local business tax. Hindi pwedeng sa probinsya magbayad kasi hindi yan tax na imposable by the province. Ano naman ang pwedeng kolektahin ng city? Taxes imposable by cities. The city may levy the taxes, fees, and charges which the province or municipality may impose. So lahat yun, transfer tax, amusement tax, sand and gravel tax, franchise tax, fixed tax on etc. etc. Local business tax, mayor's permit, pwedeng singilin niya ng city. The rates of taxes that the city may levy may exceed the maximum rates allowed for the province or municipality but by not more than 50% except the rates of professional and amusement tax. So aside from professional and amusement, yung professional kasi fixed yan at 300. Yung amusement tax, may rate naman yan. So halimbawa, yung transfer tax, kinukolekta ng province, 0.5%, di ba? Maximum yan. Magkano, ano ang rate na pwedeng kolektahin ng city? 0.75%. So 0.5% plus 50% of 0.5. So 0.75%. Pero yung professional tax, 300 lang talaga yan. Yan. A city may impose a maximum transfer tax of 0.75% of 1% of the selling price or fair market value of the property sold. Problem. On June 2018, Ben sold to his residential land located in Quezon City. Binenta, residential land with an area of 2,000 square meters. The zonal value per square meter is 3,000. By the way, what is zonal value? Market value per Department of Finance or BIR. While the fair market value per assessor's office is 1,800. Yan yung assessor's market value. The lot is sold at 2,300 per square meter. That is the selling price. At the time of sale, the land is being leased to lessee. Question. How much is the capital gains tax? Hindi naman natin pinag-usapan yan. Ha? Pero na-discuss yan sa atin ni Dr. Cedric. Di ba? Capital gains tax. Anong tax rate? Of course, 6%. Anong tax base? The highest among the following. Selling price. Pagkano yung selling price? 2,300. Assessor's fair market value, 1,800. Zonal value, 2,000. So, anong base is 2,300? Ano? 3,000 pala yung zonal value. Yung 2,000 square meter. So, 3,000 yung zonal value. So, ang base natin will be the zonal value kasi yan ang highest among the three. So, zonal value highest, 3,000 times the number of square meters or the land area, 2,000. So, the tax base is 6 million. Times 6%. So the capital gain tax is 360,000. Now, who will pay the capital gain tax? The seller. Unless there is an agreement between the seller and the buyer that it will be the buyer. Kung nakalagay sa deed of sale. So, but normally, seller talaga. Seller ang magbabayad under the law and even in practice. Next, how much is the documentary stamp tax? Magkano bang documentary stamp tax? What is the tax rate? 1.5% sabi ng iba, but that is not correct. Hindi naman sinabi ng tax code na 1.5%. 15 pesos for every 1,000. 15 pesos for every 1,000. Tax base, the same tax base in the computation of capital gain tax. So, 6 million. Paano gagawin natin? I-divide mo ng 6 million by 1,000 and then multiply by 15%. At 15 pesos. So, i-divide mo muna by 1,000. So, bawasan ng 3 zero. Yung 6,000 multiply by 15 pesos. Yan ang ibig sabihin ng 15 pesos for every 1,000. Eh sir, di ba pareho din kung multiply natin by 1.5%? Pareho. Eh paano kung may 100? Hindi na magpapareho. Mali ka na. Halimbawa, ang base may 6 million 5 ano? 6 million and 500. Tatanggalin mo yung 500 kasi i-divide mo muna by 6 million. Ay, yung 6 million. So, 600 at 6,000. Pagkatapos, yung 500 equivalent to 15 pesos yan. So, ang babayaran mong documentary stamp tax is 6,000. Oh, na hindi pala. 90,000 and 15 pesos. Yung 6,000 times 15 plus, this is equivalent to 15. Nahihirapan kasi akong magsulat eh. Is equivalent to 15 pesos. Okay. Paano kung 100 pesos lang o 10 pesos lang? 15 pesos pa rin yan. So 90,000 and 15 pesos. Pero kung 1.5% mo yan, 90,000 lang, mali. How much is the transfer tax payable if the state has fixed the tax rate at 3/4 of 1%? 6 million times 3/4% or 0.75%. Magkano? 30,000. Now, who is required to pay the documentary stamp tax? Under the law, the seller. Lahat naman yan sa seller eh. But in practice, ang nagbabayad niyan is the buyer. Napagkaugalian na buyer. But that should be indicated in the asculatilia in the deed of sale. Now, itong transfer tax, definitely, buyer ito. Abay, mas marami palang babayaran yung buyer. No. Itong mas malaki plus yung notarization fee. Seller din yan. Yan ang malalaki. Yung notarization fee, pwedeng 1%. Pero under the law, dapat yung documentary stamp tax sa seller. But napagkaugalian na, I do not know in your place, but dito sa amin, napagkaugalian na buyer ang nagbabayad. At ang transfer tax, definitely buyer. Kasi ikaw nang naglalakad ng mga papeles para ma-transfer sa pangalan mo eh. Who is liable to pay the transfer tax? Of course. Under the law, the seller din. Pero ang talagang magbabayad na dyan ay yung buyer. Sabi ng local government code, seller. Pero mahahabol mo pa ba yung seller? So, in practice, ang talagang nagbabayad na dyan is the buyer. Kasabihin ng seller, nandyan na sa iyo lahat. Ako pang sisingilin mong, sasabihin mong magbayad niyan. Bahala ka na kung ayaw mong bayaran yan. Eh di wag mo nang i-transfer sa pangalan mo. Oh, di ba? So in practice, it is the buyer. Kasi siya nang naglalakad ng papeles. But under the law, it should be the seller. When is the due date for the payment of the transfer tax? 60 days. Pero unahin mo muna yung kasi mas urgent yung capital gains tax saka documentary stamp tax. Again, yung capital gains tax, 30 days from the date of notarization. Yung documentary stamp tax, within 5 days of the succeeding month when the transaction was perfected or notarized yung deed of sale. Pero ito, mahuhuli na ito. Kasi may 60 days ka naman. Eh kung nagkabintahan June 20, no, kailan ang deadline? August 19. Okay. Ayan na. Community tax. Ito simple lang naman ito. Idinagdag ko na. Dalawa ang taxpayers ng community tax, individual saka corporation. Sa individual muna tayo. Kasi local tax din ito eh. Individuals liable to community tax. Every inhabitant of the Philippines, 18 years of age or over. Hindi sinasabing Filipino citizen ha, inhabitant. Pero dapat 18 years of age or over. Aside from being an inhabitant and 18 years old, has been regularly employed on a wage or salary basis for at least 30 consecutive working days during any calendar year. Engaged in business or occupation. Owns real property with an aggregate assessed value of 1,000 pesos or more. Anong klase namang real property yan na hindi lalampas ng 1,000 ang assessed value? Kung lupa, baka lupa lang yan sa paso. Who is required by law to file an income tax return? Hindi naman sinabing magbayad ng income tax, kundi magfile ng ITR. The amounts payable are the following. Basic tax, 5 pesos. Additional tax, 1 peso for every 1,000 of income, regardless of whether from business exercise of profession or from property. So income sa business, income sa profession, or income sa property, halimbawa 50,000, 50 pesos yung additional. Nakit na sa puwet. Maximum is 5,000 pesos. Additional yan ha. So the maximum amount of community tax is 5,005 pesos. Kasama na yung basic tax. Kasi yung maximum sa additional is 5,000. Additional lang yan. By the way, saan ka magbabayad? In the municipality where you are a resident. Pwede bang estudyante ka ng Manila pero taga Cavite ka? Magbayad ka sa Manila? No, you are not a resident of Manila. You are a resident of Cavite. Doon ka magbabayad. But ang iba naman na humingi ng community tax certificate kahit mali naman yung lugar na binayaran, okay na yun. Dahil una, hindi naman nila alam kung saan dapat magbayad. Second, hindi naman yun sa kanila importante. Okay, next. Narda, residing in Davao City, single, had the following data during the year. Yan. Salary, 120,560. Income from coconut plantation, 167,905. Income from rice field in Naga City, 101,258. Income from business, Naga, 1,578,845. Quezon City, 985,067. How much is the community tax due? How do we compute? First, the basic tax of 5 pesos. Additional. Tatlong classification nila, salary or profession. Yung salary, 120,560 divided by 1,000 times 1 peso. Huwag mo nang multiply by 1 peso kasi pareho rin naman. Yung excess na 56, wala na yan. Okay? Wala na yan. By thousands lang. Kasi wala namang sinabing or a fraction thereof. 1 peso for every 1,000. Next, real property. Income, coconut plantation. 167,905. Income from rice field, 101,258. Yan, i-total mo, 269,163. Yung 269 lang. Tanggalin mo yung hundreds, and then yung 269, yun ang additional community tax. Sa business naman, ibang classification naman, Naga, 1,578,845. Quezon, 985,067. Total, 2,563,912. Tanggalin mo yung 912 by thousands lang or per thousand. The total additional is 2,952 plus the basic 2,957. Malaki na rin yan. Ha? Masakit na rin yan sa bulsa. Eh, how about yung corporation, juridical persons liable to community tax. Every corporation, no matter how created or organized, whether domestic or resident foreign, o kahit foreign corporation, basta resident, magbabayad ng community tax. Engaged in or doing business in the Philippines shall pay the following. So the basic tax is 500. Kung 5 pesos sa individual, 500 sa individual as a corporation. Additional, maximum additional is 10,000. 2 pesos for every 5,000 worth of real property in the Philippines. So worth, not the income, ha? Worth of real property. Anong ibig sabihin ng worth na yan? During the preceding year, based on the valuation used for the payment of real property tax under existing laws, found in the assessment rolls of the city or municipality where the real property is situated. So anong ibig sabihin? 2 pesos for every 5,000 of assessed value, not the fair market value in the assessed tax declaration, kundi assessed value. As yung sabi dito, owned by it during the preceding year, based on the valuation used for the payment of the real property tax. Next. 2 pesos for every 5,000 of gross receipts or earnings derived by it from its business in the Philippines during the preceding year. Gross receipts, ha? Hindi yung income mismo, hindi yung net income. Sabi dito, gross receipts. Okay, let us have a problem. Ah, ito muna. The dividends received by a corporation from another corporation, however, shall, for the purpose of the additional tax, be considered as part of the gross receipts or earnings. The term corporation includes partnerships. No matter how created or organized, joint stock companies, joint accounts, associations or insurance companies, but does not include GPPs. Ang ibig sabihin dito, general professional partnership are not required to pay community tax. Kaya lang, pag hindi ka nagbayad niyan, hindi ka makakakuha ng makakakuha ng mayor's permit. Makikipag-away ka, pabayaran mo na lang kahit hindi naman dapat. At hindi naman yan corporation. Ang corporation, yung business partnership, pero yung GPP, hindi. Okay, problem. Uy, nandun na agad yung sagot, ha. A corporation na the following data, gross sale, 2,580,000, cost of goods sold, operating expenses, dividend from B corporation, office building. Gross sales, 2 million. Ayun mo ng basic tax, 500, ah. Yung individual, 5 pesos. Ito, 500. Additional, gross sales plus the dividend. Kasi gross, kasama rin yung sa definition ng gross receipts. So total, 2,549,780. I-divide mo by 5,000. Yung excess, never mind. So the result is 529 times 2 pesos. Kasi 2 pesos for every 5,000. So 1,058. Yung office building naman, 1,854,009 divided by 5,000 equals 370. Never mind yung centavos. Times 2, 740. So total community tax payable is 2,298.